Do you know anything about the XOR function?
No.
99% of Excel users don't fully understand how Excel handles logical tests. And this knowledge is fundamental to many areas of Excel, from advanced filters, formulas, conditional formatting, just to name a few. Let's look at the common logic functions that you might think are easy, like AND, OR, NOT, and XOR. Sorry, I said XOR, not THOR, as in exclusive OR. Sorry, things are a bit slow for him at the moment with the actor's strike and all. I'll call it XOR just to avoid any confusion. Do you know anything about the XOR function?
No.
Thought so. Maybe you can get a part-time job. Keep yourself busy.
Get a job? Serious?
I have a job. Do you know what my job is? I save the planet. Maybe you should get a job.
I have a job.
Really? Hitting the machine with the words that come out of it? Oh, this is knowledge. Knowledge is power. No, it's not. Knowledge is not power. That's power. The brain is a muscle, and that's a muscle, and that's a muscle. They are all muscles. This is all muscle. So I am covered in brains, and I have more brains than you.
Okay, well, with all those brains, you should be able to keep up, because I'm going to show you the limitations of these functions and the alternatives. Plus, I'll show you why you don't even need to use if a lot of the time and what to do instead, which can vastly improve your formulas. This knowledge can be the difference between writing monstrous nested if formulas like this that contains 15 ifs and 5 ceiling functions, and this formula that returns the exact same result without using if at all. Lastly, I'll show you under the hood of how Excel uses logic in arrays, enabling you to perform calculations you can't do with the built-in logic functions. And along the way, I'll drop some tips and tricks that will give you Excel superpowers. Buckle up. The logic functions AND OR NOT and exclusive OR all return a single true or false result. These are Boolean values, and in Excel, they are a data type all of their own. The Boolean logic is just a form of algebra where all values are reduced to either true or false. In Excel, true can also be represented with a 1 and false with a 0. Imagine you oversee Shield's high security e-commerce store that sells cutting edge tech and gear. Your inventory is vast, including stealth suits, energy shields, and Quinjets. You've been meticulously monitoring the purchasing behaviors of some of your esteemed agents, along with the accumulation of their Avenger points, which they earn through a variety of missions and tasks. And these accumulated Avenger points can be redeemed for exclusive gear upgrades or access to classified intelligence and missions.
Oh, by the way, have you
heard from Tony Stark and Captain America?
Oh, funny you should ask, because Tony Stark is hosting an exclusive gathering of superheroes at Avengers Tower.
I haven't received a single phone call.
Oh, well, invitations will be sent out to those who've spent $100 or more at Shield and have 300 or more Avenger points, so let's see if you qualify. In column F here, I can use the AND function to find which customers spend $100 or more and have 300 or more Avenger points. Now, the AND function takes a series of logical tests and returns true where all tests return true and false where any test is false. So you can see here, Tony Stark is going to get an invitation to his own party, as is Stephen Strange and Carol Danvers. Sorry, Thor, he didn't make the cut.
Am I disappointed that they didn't invite me to fight with them? No.
Okay. Tony also wants to know how many invitations to send out. I can convert these true and false values into their numeric equivalents of 1 and 0 with the double unary, which is simply two minus signs. And now I can easily add them up. Now I'll undo that, because another way I can add them up without coercing them first is inside the sum function. Here I add the double unary in front of the range of cells. However, I don't even need to use the AND function. I can simply write the logical test inside parentheses and multiply them by one another. And notice here I haven't used the double unary, and this is because performing a math operation on Boolean values also coerces them into their numeric equivalents. Now, at this point, you're probably wondering which is best, and the answer is whichever you prefer. In this scenario, there's no clear winner, but there are some limitations to the AND function that you don't get with the pure logical tests, that I'll cover in more detail later. Now, with all these solutions, I still need to calculate the logical tests one row at a time before I can add them up to find out how many invitations I'm sending out. In this scenario, it makes sense to do so because I need to identify which customers to send the invitations to versus just finding out how many to print. But that's not always the case, and I'll share a solution to this later. For now, there are a few takeaways to recap. The double unary coerces true and false values into their numeric equivalents, as do math operations, and multiplying logical tests is the same as using the AND function. Shield is sending out a special mission briefing to individuals who either have spent more than 100 at the Shield store or have over 300 Avenger points, or both. I can use the OR function here. So where purchases are greater than or equal to 100, or Avenger points are greater than or equal to 300. Now the OR function takes a series of logical tests and returns true where one or more logical tests return true, and false where they all return false. Looks like you didn't qualify for the special mission briefing either. Sorry, Thor. Anywho, again, I can coerce the Boolean true and false values to their numeric equivalents with the double unary. And I can write it without using OR by adding the logical tests. So simply wrap each logical test in parentheses, then where purchases are greater than equals 100, close parentheses, plus, open parentheses for the new logical test where Avenger points are greater than or equal to 300, and then copy it down. Now notice that where both logical tests are true, the result is 2 because true plus true is the same as 1 plus 1. Now in some cases this might be the desired result, but here I only want to give the customers who met the criteria one briefing. It wouldn't make sense to send out the briefing twice. A solution is to wrap the logical tests in the sign function. A sign converts positive values to ones, zeros remain a zero, and negative values to minus one. In this scenario, there's no benefit to using the sign function over the OR function, but later we'll see where sign may be useful. Takeaways from this example are adding logical tests treats them as OR criteria, and the sign function can be used to convert results to one where more than one logical test is true. Nick Fury wants to encourage the superheroes who've not yet made a purchase at the Shield store. These superheroes will be given a special introductory offer to encourage them to make their first purchase. We can identify customers who haven't made a purchase using the NOT function. So equals NOT, purchases greater than zero. Of course, we can also write this with a simple logical test. Equals purchases equals zero. Let's say we wanted to identify customers who had made a purchase. It could be written with NOT like this. Equals NOT, purchases equals zero. Or as a logical test, equals purchases not equal to zero. Which is best? Well, there's no distinct winner here, but personally, I find the double negative in a NOT function more difficult to write than the simple logical tests. The XOR function stands for exclusive OR and returns true when the number of true inputs is odd and false when the number of true inputs is even. No, it hurts your head. But the easiest way to think of XOR is with the light switch scenario. Let's say we have two light switches that control the same light, one at each end of a hall or a staircase. The light is only on when the two switches are in different positions. Thor here is organising a special feast in Asgard and wants to invite friends who've either spent less than $100 or have less than 200 Avenger points, but not both, to share the joy and delicious Asgardian dishes. Like other functions, we simply enter the logical test, so equals XOR, where the last purchase is less than 100 and Avenger points are less than 200. Oh, you finally qualify for something, Thor. Just a shame it's your own dinner. Now we could also write this with logical test nested in isOdd. Remember, we want it to return true when the number of true results are odd and false when the number of true results are even. So equals isOdd inside parentheses, where purchases are less than 100, close parentheses, plus where Avenger points are less than 200, close parentheses on my logical test, and close is odd. So which approach is best? Well, in this scenario, I guess that XOR might be more efficient to calculate than the pure logical tests inside is odd, but it probably wouldn't be noticeable on less than 100,000 rows of data. If, however, you want to return an array of Boolean values, then is odd is the winner because XOR can only return a single result. Now, more on returning arrays in a moment. Thor here wants to give each customer who's not made a purchase a super bonus of 2 invitations to his Asgardian dinner so they can bring a plus one. If thoughtful. Now with if, we'd write it equals if last purchase equals 0, then 2, else 0. However, when we require a numeric result from a logical test, the if function is often redundant. In this case, we could simply write this formula equals open parentheses, last purchase equals 0, close parentheses, times 2. No double unary is required because I'm multiplying the result of the logical test by 2, which coerces it into its numeric equivalent. There's no standout winner here, but I'd hazard a guess that the pure logical test will be slightly faster for Excel to calculate, but not significantly on small data sets. The takeaway here is that if often isn't required when the outcome of the formula is numeric. Nested ifs, or the newer ifs function, enable you to perform a logical test, return a result if the test is true, if not, move on to the next logical test, and so on until it finds a true outcome. In this scenario, Nick Fury wants to reward customers with a coupon worth 20% of their last purchase where they spent more than $200, or 10% of their last purchase where they spent more than $100. We can write this in a nested if formula or the newer ifs function. Let's use ifs. So ifs the last purchase is greater than $200, then the last purchase times 0.2 for 20%. Else if the last purchase is greater than $100, then the last purchase times 0.1 for 10%. If both of these are false, then the last criteria must be true, so we just enter true there, and 0 for the result. Or we could simplify it with pure logical tests. So in parentheses, where the last purchase is greater than 200, then the last purchase times 0.1 plus, where the last purchase is greater than 100, then the last purchase times 0.1. Note here that both logical tests are performed, which is why both only calculate 10% of the coupon value, because once combined, customers who spent 200 will receive 20% in total. So which is better? The ifs or nested if formula will be more efficient for Excel to calculate because they stop calculating at the first logical test that returns true, whereas the pure logical test formula will always calculate both logical tests. The takeaway is ifs and nested if formulas stop calculating at the first logical test that returns true, and this means it's crucial to get the order of logical tests correct. For more on this, check out my comprehensive tutorial on if, nested if, and ifs formulas. OR and XOR and NOT can only return a single value. That is, they can't spill results or return arrays of Boolean values when nested inside other functions. And this means you can't use them in functions like filter, sum product, etc. But we can use pure logical tests with multiply for and plus for OR. Let's say Nick Fury wants to know how many customers spent more than $100 in the Shield store. Here I can reference the last purchases and check if they're all greater than 100. The formula spills the results. That is, it returns an array of Boolean values. Now I can also do this in a single cell. The double unary coerces the true and false results from the logical tests to their numeric equivalents of 1 and 0, and then sum adds them up. Pretty cool. Nick Fury is demanding, and now he wants to find the value of purchases where customers spent more than 100 or have more than 200 Avenger points. With pure logical tests, I can reference the whole range of purchases and test if they're greater than 100, or if Avenger points are greater than 200, and this returns an array of results. Now I need to wrap the logical tests in the sine function to avoid double counting here, because I'm performing my logical tests on different columns, which means there's a risk that both criteria could be true. And then lastly, to calculate the value of these sales, I simply multiply the logical tests by the purchase price. If I evaluate the formula, you can see the arrays being returned. The logical tests are added together, then sine converts the positive values to 1. And lastly, the purchase values are multiplied by the logical test array to return the sales that meet the criteria, which sum then adds up. Nick Fury's last request is for a list of customers whose last purchase is more than $100 or who have more than 200 Avenger points. And I can use the filter function for this, which is available in Excel 2021 onward. Filter references the array or cell range that you want filtered, in this case, the table of sales. Then we specify which rows to return with an array of Boolean values, one for each row. Remember, OR and NOT and XOR can't return arrays. So here we must use pure logical tests to identify which rows I want returned. So here I want the purchases that are greater than 100 or, which is plus, where Avenger points are greater than 200. And the formula spells the table containing the rows that meet the criteria. Now, if I evaluate the logical tests, which I'm adding together, notice it returns 2 for some rows. Now, I could fix this with the sine function, but here's the twist that 99.9% of Excel users don't know. Excel will treat any positive or negative number as true where it requires a Boolean value. So, it doesn't matter here if some rows are returning 2 or 1, both are considered true. This also applies in other areas of Excel where Boolean results are required, like conditional formatting rules, etc. With filter, there's no risk of it returning a row twice. It simply wants to know if a row should be included or not. Therefore, I don't need to use the sine function to convert the array to ones and zeros. Now, this is just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to the filter function. It's one of my favorite new functions in Excel. And now that you have logic in Excel mastered, you're ready to maximize the use of filter to do some amazing things. So watch this video next to get my insider tips on the filter function. Have you got any questions, Thor?
Question, what are infinity stones?
I meant Excel questions. Thanks for watching.